So good day. I am Chelo Odibi Reyes and I am the first presenter for our group. So our group is assigned to discuss all about enterprise resource planning system. So what are the objectives for this particular chapter? So first, to understand the general functionality and key elements of ERP systems. Second, to understand the various aspects of ERP configurations, including servers, databases, and the use of both software. Third, to understand the purpose of data warehouses as a strategic tool and recognize the issues related to the design, maintenance, and operation of a data warehouse. Next, to recognize the risks associated with ERP implementation, and lastly, be aware of key considerations related to ERP implementation. Next, what are the problems with non-ERP systems? So first, in-house designing limits, connectivity outside the company. Second, tendency towards separate IS within the firm. So it composed of lack of integration limits, communication within the company. Next is a strategic decision-making tool, not supported. Next is long-term maintenance costs high. And lastly, limits ability to engage in process re-engineering. So next is the traditional IS model. So it composed of closed database architecture. So under this, it has a similar in concept to flat file approach. So data remains the property of the application. Fragmentation limits communications. Next is the existence of numerous distinct and independent databases. So under this is redundancy and anomaly problems. Next is paper-based. So it requires multiple entry of data. It also it is also a status of information unknown at key points. So now let's go to ERP system. So what is an ERP system? It is a multi-module application software that helps a company manage the important parts of its business in an integrated fashion. So what are the key features of it? So it includes a smooth and seamless flow of information across organizational boundaries. Next, standardized environment with shared database, independent application, and integrated operations. So what are the two main ERP applications? So first, we have core applications or the online transaction processing. Core application also is a transaction processing system. So it supports the day-to-day operational activities of the business. It also supports the mission critical tasks through inquiries or operational databases. It also includes sales and distribution, business planning, production planning, shop floor control, and logistic modules. So the other ERP application is the business analysis application. It is also called online analytical processing or OLAP. So it decision support tool for management critical tasks through analytical investigation of complex data associations. So it supplies management with real-time information and facilities timely decisions to improve performance and achieve competitive advantage. So it also includes decision support, modeling, information retrieval, ad hoc reporting, and what-if analysis. So OLAP also supports management critical tasks through analytical investigation of complex data associations captured in data warehouses. So what are those warehouses? So first, consolidation, it is the aggregation or roll up of data. Next, drill down allows the user to see data in selectively increasing level of details. And lastly, slicing and dicing, it enables the users to examine data from different viewpoints to uncover trends and patterns. So that's all Thank you.